3, 2, 1.
Welcome back to the channel. So today we're going to talk about 5 different things we can do after lockdown has finished. They're going to be iconic things to do in Saigon, historical things to experience and learn, cultural things, ways to relax and kick back, and also some nature exploring.
Some of these activities you can do in an afternoon, others are a day trip away from Saigon, and the final ones are weekend trip ideas. And they fit a variety of budgets, some activities are free, and some of them are bougie price. So let's get into it. First up is iconic, and we're going to talk about the cafe apartments on Nguyen Hue Walking Street. It's a really iconic site right in the middle of District 1 of a huge block of cafes, and it's a super popular location too that you must visit if you get the chance.
When we visited it, we found that the coffees are quite expensive, maybe ranging around 70,000 to 100,000 VND. Now, that might not sound too expensive if you're in the Western world, but in Vietnam, you can get coffees on the side of the road for 15,000, like 50p, so it's really expensive compared to that. But the coffees are quite decent and there's a range of drinks really, isn't there?
It also provides a really good view, a great place to people watch for the people walking on Nguyen Hue, and a really good view of the skyline in District 1. One extra cost is you must pay 3,000 dong to take the lift up, or you can walk up the stairs, and there is lots of choice of different cafes, so you can find one that suits what you like.
It's also a perfect Instagrammable spot if you want to get that gram, which obviously is a must these days.
Gram or it didn't happen.
Exactly. So the next thing we're going to talk about is the history section, and of course it's the must-see thing to do in Saigon, the Ho Chi Minh tunnels. These tunnels are super famous, and when we went, we took a tour to go there from District 1. This included the bus ride to and from the place and also a tour guide. We paid around $20 per person, which is a little bit pricey, but when you want a tour, that's the price that you've got to pay.
When you get to Ho Chi Minh, you'll have an English-speaking Vietnamese tour guide that will teach you about the traps and the techniques that the Vietnamese soldiers used during the war. And the most special thing to do is to climb into the tunnels for yourself. Now, they are pretty tight down there, but they've been widened for some larger Western tourists, so it's not too bad, although very hot down there. And finally, if it's your kind of thing, you have the opportunity to shoot some real rifles at the shooting range. I think it's pretty expensive, but if that's what you want to do, you can take the opportunity in the Ho Chi Minh tunnels. One other option under our history section is to visit the War Remnants Museum in the center of District 1, where you can see loads of tanks, helicopters, and other vehicles that were used during the war, and to see some amazing photographs taken from the history. For culture, we suggest visiting the Buu Long Pagoda or Golden Pagoda. Just a little bit out of the city center in District 9, around 1 hour drive, is a really great place to visit. It's a super unique golden colored pagoda where you can walk around the grounds and you can climb right to the top so you can see a great view of all the surroundings.
Another great thing about the pagoda is that it's free, so it's completely free to enter the pagoda and walk around the grounds, which is great. We spent around an afternoon there, which we found was long enough.
Yeah, if you hadn't seen it before, you wouldn't believe that it was in Saigon. Really great place to visit, and best of all, it's free. For nature, we recommend the Tan Lap Floating Village. In the province of Long An, it will take you around 2 hours by bus or motorbike to get there, and we recommend it as a weekend trip, as there's accommodation there.
The grounds are really beautiful in Tan Lap Floating Village. You can spend the whole afternoon strolling around the thin, winding little paths. You can also pay for some tours, such as the cable boat tour or the bird watching tour, to see the birds flying around at sunset. We did both of these things and would definitely recommend them. And they were quite affordable too, maybe around 200 to 300,000 per person.
Unlike most things where we might recommend for you to go in the dry season, this one is actually one that's better to do in the wet season because you can walk through a stone platform that is in the river, and it looks much cooler when the water is right up to the platform than when it's dry season. So if you find a dry day during rainy season, that's the best time to go.
So if you want to know more about the Tan Lap experience, we'll link the video down below and you can check it out.
Another option under the nature category is to go to Cat Tien National Park. Now this one is a bit further from the city, around 5 hours by bus. We took a local bus and that was not that fun of an experience, but the location is really cool. It's a huge national park that you can explore. They've got waterfalls and they even have the crocodile lake, where if you're lucky, you can see some real crocodiles there. The cost for entry to Cat Tien National Park is only 150,000 dong. Because it's far from the city, we recommend that you stay overnight, and there are some hotels on site and around the location.
The next nature attraction we'd like to talk about is Giang Dien Waterfall, or Giang Dien, depending on where you're from in Vietnam. Now this waterfall is a bit hidden, is a hidden gem in Saigon, and it's around maybe a 1-2 hour drive there from District 2. It's really beautiful to walk around and see the waterfall. There are lots of people swimming or fishing there, or you can just chill by the on-site cafe like we did. The entrance fee cost to the waterfall is around 70,000 VND, which isn't too bad at all, and we spent the whole day there, which was perfect. You can even have lunch on-site at the restaurant, so that's great. So now let's move on to the relaxing part of this video. We recommend quite a bougie hotel called Lam Retreats. This is a 5-star luxury resort, and we got there by speedboat, which was included in the price of the hotel. It was around $200 per night, which sounds expensive, but it was a really lovely experience. We went on Boxing Day for a special occasion.
I think it's not your everyday kind of hotel, but for a special occasion, it was perfect. They had delicious food there from the restaurant on site, as well as an all-you-can-eat buffet and really good facilities. You can walk around the beautiful natural grounds, as well as having a swimming pool and the gym on site. So that was excellent. The rooms were very comfortable, and you even get your own personal butler and their WhatsApp, so you can contact them anytime, like if your room floods, like ours did.
Story time in the video down below.
So if Lam Retreats is a little out of your budget, there are lots of other affordable options too. Another good one is Mekong Home, which is in the Mekong Delta. We traveled down there for one night at the cost of 1.2 million for a double room between us. It's a wonderful family-run business with also a swimming pool and delicious food there, which is another great option.
Another great option is going to Tho Ecolodge, which we did for my birthday last year. Now this was around $50 a night, which was a great price. It's a bit further away than Mekong Home or Lam, maybe 3 hours by bus to go to Tho, but it was definitely worth it. We stayed there for two nights and enjoyed swimming in the pool and also cycling around the grounds on little bicycles. So there you have it. There are 5 ideas from us of things you can do after Saigon's lockdown. Let us know down below if you've been to any of these places already or which one you really want to try.
For all of the ideas on the list today, we have separate videos. You can check the link in the description to find out more about them. And in the meantime, if you want to find out about when Vietnam's borders might be opening, you can check out this video to learn more about Vietnam's visa situation. And down below, you can see a playlist of all of our beautiful travel vlogs here in Vietnam. So thanks for watching and see you next time.
Thank you guys. Bye.
Bye-bye.